In mathematics, we often solve for x, but what about y? Today, let's talk about why 2 equals 1. Or does it? Let's start with two variables that have the same value. We can call one a, call the other b, and set them equal to each other. So we have a equals b. Now we can multiply both sides by a, and since we're doing the same thing to both sides of the equation, we're all good to go. So we have a times a equals a times b, or in other words, a squared equals a times b. Now let's subtract b squared from both sides, and again, since we're doing the same thing to both sides of the equation, we're all good to go. So we have a squared minus b squared equals a times b minus b squared. If you recall back in algebra class, you might have learned about difference of squares and the greatest common factor. So we can actually rewrite a squared minus b squared as a plus b times a minus b. If you're not sure about that, go ahead and try and multiply that out and just verify that that does in fact equal a squared minus b squared. And if you notice on the other side of our equation, both terms are being multiplied by b, so we can pull out that greatest common factor of b and leave us with b times a minus b. Notice that there is an a minus b on both sides of our equation, so let's just go ahead and divide both sides by a minus b to cancel those out, leaving us with a plus b equals b. But remember, a equals b, right? A has the same value as b, so we could rewrite a plus b as b plus b, and it would have the same value. Or in other words, we have 2b equals b. Since both sides of our equation contain a b, we can divide both sides by b, leaving us with 2 equals 1. Go ahead and pause the video here and see if you can figure out how this is true, because can 2 really equal 1? What happened? So remember that a equals b. So what happens if we take a minus b? Well, if a and b are the same number, subtracting a minus b will give us 0. So look back at this step here where we divided by a minus b. We were really dividing by 0. We just didn't notice it because it wasn't written as a 0, it was written as a minus b. This is just one example of how dividing by 0 can end up with some crazy results. If you want a more formal explanation of why we can't divide by 0, let me know in the comments below, but I hope you enjoyed this math magic trick showing why we can't divide by 0.